Am I going?
I think so. Hey, y'all.
What's up? Okay, so we're gonna do another flip and drag kind of thing on this mirror for Tammy Terrell. It's another one. She's ordered another one. This time she wants maroon cream black with the hologram. So I had to custom make a maroon because I didn't have maroon. I used This is what I use to make the maroon. Primary blue, primary yellow, primary red. Actually, let's put them in the order that you use them. You use mostly red, a little bit of blue, and a touch of yellow to your desired liking. Whatever it is that you like, that's the color that I ended up with that I thought looked most like a good maroon. And then let's see, just some cream color. I think this is just simply or simple. What is it? Simply acrylic. And the hologram. Yes, it looks white, but it dries with a hologram look. Let me see if I can show you on this other one. Here's the one I did for D. I haven't, or one of the ones that I've got. I haven't varnished yet because it's only been a week and I like to let them dry, well on into a week, maybe into the second week, because if not, then the varnish doesn't look good and it'll start bubbling and all kinds of stuff. Anyway, this is what the hologram does to it. See the holographic, I don't know, the shimmer on there? That's what that hologram does to the paint. So, pretty cool, right? And black. But what I was going to do before I do this, I'm going to make sure I'm going to put a little bit of this. I'm going to do this over here. Put a little bit of this pouring medium. Not much, just a little bit. Maybe just a hair more than that. Just to. I'm going to put it in all of them. Just to ensure that. The paint, I've already got it in my black, just to be in, to ensure that the paint doesn't crack, because I have learned, because again, I'm still learning all of this. I have learned that this gloss pouring medium, putting that in with your paint, gives it flexibility and hopefully avoid cracks. Found that out the other day whenever I was looking at a little painting that I did, and I noticed some cracks in it, so I start Googling, take myself to Google school and YouTube school, and I come to learn, and that made it thick. I come to learn that this pouring medium seems to, I got that a little thick, so I'm going to add some water. It helps add flexibility to it, so that's a good thing. Okay, there's that one. Let's check this one. I just sneezed right before I started this, so now my nose is running. It's warm in here. I had to turn on the little electric heater to get it warm because I'm gonna try doing some resin work after I do this pour, hopefully. I gotta turn this off though because it's messing with my light. A little heater keeps trying to kick on and off, and it's making my lights blink on and off. I don't know that that's a good thing. Here's somebody's lawnmower going outside. Lucky me, I don't have to have that issue right now because my son mowed my yard a few days back. Okay, that's good. Now I got a cough. I got a tickle in my throat. I still feel like this one's too thick. I don't want to get it too thin though, because if I do, then I have to start adding all three paints in order to get this color again, and that's just not fun. I probably should have just went ahead and got online and bought a tube, which I may do at some point, but it's like, what was it, like $12 for a tube this size. And that's just not, I don't have enough orders for a maroon right now in order for me to justify buying that. But if this turns out, then we might actually just go ahead and buy one. Okay, I think that's good. All right, so I'm gonna do, you've seen me do these before. So I'm gonna turn on some music back here and we're just gonna chill out while I do this acrylic pour. How about that? Sound good? Hopefully, and see, it throws me into a commercial. I hate it whenever it does that. I've watched enough commercials. YouTube. Okay, here we go. Just kind of chill out back there and see what happens here. Let's make some magic. I know I turned it on. Okay, what do we want to put first here? I'm going to say just a touch of black in the bottom. Not much, just a touch. I don't want too much. I don't want the black to overpower this. Next to the black, I'm going to do that hologram because I think it looks badass there. Cream. All right, guys, here we go. Oh, that's gonna look really pretty together. Very good, very good. This one I'm gonna drag. And this one I'm going to poke a pin with and let it float around there. Let's hope it works out that way. I'm going to scoot this back over to that so we can still use it. Remember, all this paint here, that everything that lands here is going to get taken off anyway. So we might as well put this up here for it to flow. Poke a hole in this and see how it happens.
Thank you.
Oh, look how pretty that is. Look at that little cup. Check that out. Good color choices, Tammy. My lawnmower neighbor running their lawnmower while I'm right in the middle of trying to do this. This is how well my art therapy goes, right? But it is still therapeutic, even though they're back there mowing their yard in the background. That's okay. All right, let's tilt this out, y'all. Kind of want to try to keep that little area. So... I'm not sure what this song is, but I kind of like the music, but it keeps going to these that are narrated, so I'm not so sure. Okay, let's go back this way. Good color choices, Tammy. I love this. Try to use some of this, get this black over here. I think that would look great. Too bad that's not going to be there. Get some of this. I want some of this right here. There. Oh, yeah. I think that's very good. Very, very cool. Tilt a little more of that off over there. Maybe get this line right here up that way a little bit. A little bit more. A little bit more. Okay, now let's take it back. Back down so it doesn't look so stretched. Oh, this is a very good one. Her other one turned out really good too. I'm gonna have to consult her on colors. She does good. Okay. What do y'all think? Good? Still got quite a bit of paint on it, so I'm going to tilt a little bit more on. Okay, I'm going to torch this one more time. I'm gonna have to order some more of the hologram because all it got me was this is the third mirror, I think. Three mirrors. 1 2-ounce bottle. This little bitty 2-ounce bottle that is seven something on Amazon, I think. Yeah, $7, something like that. Got me three paintings. So, and I expect to get more than that out of a tube of paint. Of course, tubes are different, but I'm going to have to get me some more hologram because it seems to be quite popular. Okay, I'm going to take this. If I can get my hands cleaned off, I know I said I was going to quit, but I think we're looking good here. Wow, I love these colors. Okay, I'm going to get the camera here and bring you down. What do y'all think? Gotta imagine this section right here will be gone. Well, where is it? It's right there. Right there where you see the tape. But the rest of it, do believe, is looking pretty badass. What do y'all think? Good color choices, huh? Wish that light wasn't up there, hindering my little video here. But, oh wow, that's insane how cool that is. I love that hologram. Or my, what's it called? Glamour dust. Glamour dust. It's the shiznit. Alrighty. I hope y'all liked the video. Let me turn this down a hair so I'm not yelling. I hope you liked the video and I hope you watch more. I will be posting. I'll be live tomorrow night. So come hang out with me tomorrow night while we do another one of these. I've got special colors already picked out. It's going to be a special night. It's a birthday gift, and it's going to be fun. Y'all come join me tomorrow night. All right, I'll see you. Peace!